So in our final programming exercise, I want you to put everything together and build a particle filter. And I'm supplying you with code that has as gaps pretty much the two functions you just programmed, move and sense, and some additional code that I copied from class, the particle filter code that you're familiar with, and also some code that helps you test your routines so you can make sure they're correct. The key new thing you have to do is you have to work on the noise. There's no bearing noise and steering noise and distance noise. The code that you wrote didn't have any of those. I want you now to modify your procedures to accommodate this noise, steering noise, distance noise, and bearing noise, and all of it should be Gaussian. So let's go all the way to the end. There's two test cases. This is the first test case, which are uncommented, so we can run it. And what this is, it creates a sequence of robot motions. Each of these time steps over turns a little bit and moves forward. It also has 8 measurements, which are the bearings to those 4 different landmarks. And if I go up a little bit in the code, then you'll find that the ground truth final position was 93, 75, and 5.2. When I run it, it runs the routine particle filter with those motions and those measurements as an input, and it produces an estimate, which is 94, 71, and 5.2, which isn't exactly the same as up here, but it's close. So this is a particle filter working. I'm supplying quite a few functions for you. You should look around. One is called particle filters. That's exactly the same code we used in class and constructed together. I just copied it over. So if you look through this, you'll find hopefully no surprise here. And I'm also supplying you the measurement probability function, which is part of the implementation. So let's just go there. So here's the measurement probability function. There's something non-trivial here. I compute the predicted measurement, and then I compute a Gaussian that measures the distance between the measurements passed into the routine and the predicted measurements computed over here. That's all happening down here. Here's my Gaussian function with the exponential. And then I return my Gaussian error. There should be no surprise here. What's important is a little modification to the sense function that you haven't seen before. I can now give the sense function a parameter, and if I give it the parameter 0, it switches off the noise model. So you will need the noise model for forward simulation of the robot, but you don't need it for computing the probability of a measurement. So augment your sense function to have a flag that if it's set to 0, switches on, off the noise modeling and gets you the predicted best possible measurements. So what you have to do is, you have to find the part in the code that says only add modified code below here. You have to copy over your move function and then work in, as it says in the instructions, the steering noise and the distance noise. That is Gaussian noise. I hope you know how to do this. Then you also have to plug in the sense function. And you also have to plug in bearing noise and make sure there's a flag that allows you to switch off the bearing noise. And it should be an optional flag, so it should have a default value of the bearing noise being on, otherwise your code won't run. So here's how we will test your code. If you go to test case number 2, then I wrote a few extra functions for you that allow you to test your particle filters on many, many instances, just like the ones we'll be using for testing that are all randomly generated. Let me just go through that code line by line. Our test case will be 8 steps long. There's the same motions vector we had before of a slight turn on a circle. Generate ground truth gives us a sequence of measurements and a robot position that we can split as follows using a robot simulation. Then you run your particle filter over here, and the function check output down here compares the final robot position, the ground truth position, with your particle filter position, estimated position from here, and gives us a single flag whether this is all correct. So let me just do this. We generated a robot that finished at final location 20 minus 29 and this orientation over here. The particle filter came up with 22 minus 31 and 0.14, which is close to the originals. And my code check said true. Let me run it again. Different values, still true. Run it again. Different values, still true. Now, it could happen that the code check says false. I just ran it 20 times and it said true for me every single time. But I've seen it say false. And the reason is it's a randomized algorithm. It's a particle filter. It might actually not have a particle at the right place. So when we test your routine, we're going to code our own code check output. We have our own function for this. But we're going to run it multiple times. And if you get it wrong once, that's not a big deal. So in summary, you will have to comment out all the test cases again. All you have to do is supply the missing function. You can test the correctness yourself. You can basically grade yourself with this test case over here. But when you submit it, have those commented out, because we have our own test software. And all we're going to test is whether your particle filter gives us a good estimate when we choose randomly the initial position of the robot, measurements, motions, and so on.